Meghan Markle could be in for big trouble if she breaks with a long-established Christmas rule the Queen adopted for the royal family's celebrations at Sandringham House in Norfolk, expert Martin Townsend warned. Meghan Markle is set to spend her second Christmas with the royal family at Sandringham House in Norfolk, the first time since her marriage to Prince Harry in April. But rather than facing the relaxing time surrounded by her new family, the Duchess of Sussex could be on track for big trouble if she commits a faux pas during the traditional Christmas Eve present exchange. Royal expert Martin Townsend warned Meghan she has to follow one of the strict Christmas rules the Queen imposes on her relatives to avoid any trouble. Speaking to Nine Network, Mr. Townsend said, "They have present giving and they are not allowed to give serious presents. Any suggestion that Meghan will give away cashmere jumpers or anything like that, if she makes that mistake she's in big trouble. Everyone has to give away jokey little presents. That's the rules. There's a lot to remember for her." The traditional giving of gag gifts goes back decades and falls in step with two more Christmas rules the Queen is sure to see followed, which include waiting for Prince Philip's permission to open any presents and the cheaper the present, the better. Prince Harry is said to have once gifted his grandmother a shower cap with the words "Ain't Life a Bitch" emblazoned on it. And proving she has a sense of humor to match her in-laws, Kate Middleton reportedly once gave Harry a "Grow Your Own Girlfriend" kit, long before Meghan Markle entered his life. Last year it was up to the Duchess of Sussex to show she could live up to the family's expectations for novelty gifts and gave the Queen something rather bizarre. Weeks after announcing their engagement, Prince Harry's then-fiancé gave Her Majesty a singing toy hamster, according to the Daily Star Online. To make a good impression on the Queen during her first Christmas at Sandringham in 2011, Kate revealed she opted for a more personal present. Speaking in a documentary interview in honor of the Queen's 90th birthday, she recalled the 2011 event, "I can remember being at Sandringham, for the first time, at Christmas," she said. "And I was worried what to give the Queen as her Christmas present. I was thinking, gosh, what should I give her? I thought, I'll make her something, which could have gone horribly wrong. But I decided to make my granny's recipe of chutney. I was slightly worried about it, but I noticed the next day that it was on the table." Kate will be allegedly spending Christmas Day with the royal family at Sandringham, ending an established tradition of splitting the day between the Queen and the Middletons to allow Prince George, Princess Charlotte and Prince Louis to spend more time with the Queen and Prince Philip. Asked about the schedule for Christmas at the royal residence, Mr. Townsend added, "It's all very, very regimented. All the royals arrive on Christmas Eve apart from the Queen, obviously, who went up on Thursday already on the train. All the rest of the royals have to arrive in strict order of importance, which already will cause a bit of friction. Arrive in order of importance and then the whole of Christmas Eve is lined out. Have an afternoon tea, have a black tie meal in the evening. There's lots of dress changes required.